It's Ibanez Month at Guitar Guitar, and today we're going to be spending a little bit of time with one of the world's most famous overdrive pedals. Let's check out the TS-808 and the TS-9 Tube Screamers. The Ibanez Tube Screamer needs absolutely no introduction, so you know what? I'm not going to give it one because everybody knows what this very famous green pedal is. And in fact, the one I've got in front of me here, this is the 45th anniversary TS-808. So what better time to celebrate the Ibanez Tube Screamer than taking a look at two of the most iconic models in the lineup. Now, there are copious amounts of, I guess we can call them clones at this point out there, because the Tube Screamer, again, being one of the most famous overdrive pedals in the world, has been replicated, it has been modded, it has been lovingly paid tribute to, but we're going to be looking at the originals today. So in this video, I'm going to spend a little bit of time just going through the sounds of each pedal, starting with the 808, going on to the TS-9, and then I'll do a bit of a back-to-back comparison with them by playing the same riff on both with roughly the same sort of setting. So by all means, if you do want to check out any of those sections, the video will be split up into chapters if you want to check them out in the description below. But let's just jump in with the one that started it all, the TS-808. So over the years, the 808 has been used by so many famous guitarists in so many different applications as well, because one of the things that I particularly love about the Tube Screamer, and to kind of give you a bit of a spoiler alert in this video as well, this beat up green one TS-9 is actually mine. That's how much I do like a Tube Screamer. I think that kind of like attests to a point that like any guitarist out there probably at some point has had a Tube Screamer. Now they are a very quite a divisive pedal, even though they are so famous as well, just because they have got such a characteristic to their tone. Often described as a mid hump to them, because it'll boost your mids. That's why they're so good with guitars. It's just because they will help you to kind of cut through a mix just that little bit more. But let's check out the TS-808 here. This is the known as the kind of lower gain option of the two, but as you'll hear in a little second, it can really get up to those levels. What I'm going to be doing as well, the Ibanez AZ that I'm going to be using for this demo here, it can do a variety of different sounds, whether it be single coils or humbuckers as well. So I'm going to be cycling through them just so you can get kind of the full scope of sounds that the 808 can handle. But let's hear my clean tone and then I'll turn it on and let's just play about with this pedal. So even though this is considered the, I guess, lower gain option of the two, even when I was kind of diming that up to that kind of top level there, I definitely wasn't feeling like it was missing any gain. Let's even go back to our neck humbucker here as well, and that's it properly dimed up to the top. And of course, lowering that gain there and the, well, the overdrive that's on the pedal will just kind of give you like more of a just a warmer sort of like pushed amp sound, which I guess that's kind of what the Tube Screamer was invented for back in the day there as well. There is a couple of other options that you can use with the Tube Screamer as well, and this is particularly kind of related to like if you're using this in kind of like a boosting sort of scenario, that you can kind of lower the overdrive all the way to the bottom. Now, this is not any kind of hard and fast rules here, but you can lower that down and actually boost your level and boost your tone. So if we're to go back to just our clean, let's go back to maybe a single coil sound just so we can kind of hear the nuances just that little bit more. And I don't know if you'll have noticed when I was playing that there that when I kind of lightened my touch just that little bit more, the pedal did clean up. And when I dug in just a little bit as well, it was breaking up, which by reducing the overdrive, I do just feel you get just a kind of little bit more options to your dynamics there. And I'll show you just again, just in case you didn't hear that properly. Which, for a pedal that's turned all the way down on the overdrive there, you're still getting a lot of breakup from the amp, which is awesome. Now, let's move over to the TS9. Just this is kind of considered to be the supercharged sort of version of the 808. A little bit more modern, even though it's still, quite a few years old at this point. The layout is exactly the same, as you can see. There is drive on the first knob. I should have made, obviously, paid attention to that on the 808 there as well. But in all honesty, it's pretty easy to understand. You've got overdrive, level, and then tone. And it's exactly the same for our TS9 here. So again, let's just cycle through some sounds, see how this guy is handling. We'll be right back. Definitely a little bit spikier is kind of my impressions of the TS9 there, certainly compared to the TS808. And I guess that's probably a reason you might see it on some modelers, particularly like the Helix, which takes the patch that they have inspiration from the TS9. It's called the Hedgehog D9, I think it's called on it. But the Hedgehog part, obviously, just because it has got that little bit kind of more spike to it as well. Both very much giving you, you know, very kind of like similar sound profiles. I definitely don't think that like one is necessarily better than the other. That's one of the kind of key things that I take away from Chip Screamers anyway. They just got like slightly different sort of feels to them. And I guess at this point here, I'm going to try and like set them up as close as possible to each other, in the sense that we can cycle through a couple of sounds and we can just see exactly what they're like kind of back to back. Now, obviously, with the pots and what the kind of pedals they are and stuff like that as well, the sounds may not be exactly the same and in terms of their settings and stuff like that, but we're gonna see this is what it'd be like obviously if you were kind of trying back to back in the shop, and I'll try and get as many kind of varieties of tones of it, but I'll kind of stick to the single coil sort of sound because that's kind of where I hear the most difference with the Tube Screamers anyway.
We'll be right back.
So hopefully that gave you an idea of the comparison between the TS9 and the TS808, and of course a few stumbles and falls across the way. I tried to get as much kind of tone out of this one guitar as possible, but of course the TS series, I guess, the Troop Screamer series, they are going to kind of react differently depending on the kind of amp you're using, depending on the kind of guitar that you're using, you know, kind of pickups are going into it. So one of the things that I really quite like about it is that it doesn't have like a straight up, it does have a very recognizable tone, as I mentioned, that kind of, you know, mid sort of hump that it does, but it fits in seamlessly with any sort of scenario. I didn't even touch on, you know, actually showing you the settings of the way that this is used with like kind of metal amplifiers and stuff like that by the using the setting that I mentioned of running the overdrive down to the bottom, driving the level all the way to the top, and then putting that in front of a distorted amplifier, particularly like a 5150, sorry, or 6505, I guess, is the fact that it will kind of give the front end of the amp a little bit of a kick, give you a little bit of a boost. It's awesome. But I also didn't even pay attention to, and if you've had some good eyes this video as well, then you'll notice I didn't even give any sort of attention to the start of the show, which is this huge Tube Screamer pillow. But hopefully you've got an idea of the difference between these two pedals. And obviously, if you're a fan of Tube Screamers, if you're not a fan of Tube Screamers, let me know down in the comments below. We'd like to know your reason why. But until next time, I've been Kieran. This has been a look at two of the most iconic overdrive pedals in the world. That's the Tube Screamer. Have a great day. I didn't want to actually hit the camera.